piano action is a system for moving the piano hammer. Movement of the key from level to the bottom of the key dip is the limit of the energy input. The action parts that ride on the capstan use that energy to drive the hammer to the string and then to reset the system so it can play again. Aftertouch occurs at the bottom of the keystroke in a well-regulated piano. It is a small safety margin that allows the hammer to escape from the driving system just before striking the string and to be held in check, ready to reset quickly when the key is released. For standard aftertouch, when the key is at the bottom of its stroke and the hammer is in check, the jack tip should just barely be clear of the knuckle and not pressed into the felt at the front of the whippin window. You should be able to wiggle the jack by its toe. If there is no aftertouch, the jack will not be able to escape. If there is too much aftertouch, the jack will be stressed between the regulation button and the whippin window at the bottom of the keystroke and may eventually break. In these exercises, we will maintain a standard let-off measurement of 3/32 of an inch. Use the little plastic gauge to check let-off, and a checking distance of 5/8 of an inch. This will allow us to focus on the relationship between key travel and blow distance in controlling aftertouch. Use the little plastic gauge to check let-off. If your checking distance isn't exactly 5/8 when you make a test, just push the hammer with the gauge. In the first exercise, you will adjust aftertouch only by moving the capstan. First, turn the capstan down until you are sure that there is no escapement. Then gradually raise the capstan, watching what happens to the jack. When it looks like the jack is going to escape, set checking with little checking gauge and see if the jack position satisfies the requirement for safe aftertouch. Continue raising the capstan a little bit at a time. Always setting checking and notice what happens to the jack. You can keep raising until you reach a point that the jack jams against the felt in the whippin window. Now, adjust aftertouch to what you think will be an acceptable position and call the instructor to check your work. In the second exercise, you will adjust Aftertouch by adjusting key tip. Prepare the model by removing any colored punchings from the front key pin, leaving only the black punchings there, and replacing the felt punching. Press carefully and observe the jack. If it's trapped, there is too much Aftertouch. A 60,000th of an inch gauge will enable you to establish a very wide Aftertouch. Add some punchings to the pin. Put the gauge on top. Press down slowly. The jack is still escaping, so we can add more punchings. Now we can see that the jack only escapes with a firm pressure on the key. We could call this 60,000th of an inch Aftertouch, but to be sure, we'll put the punchings under the felt punching. And test again. Feel this carefully. This is a very wide Aftertouch. Forty thousandths of an inch is a standard Aftertouch measurement. You can see that the jack is escaping easily. Add a punching. And test again. That looks awfully tight. So I'll move the punching underneath the felt punching. And test again. Now I'm feeling 40,000ths of an inch, a standard Aftertouch dimension. But some pianists will prefer a smaller Aftertouch. So now we'll use a 30,000ths of an inch gauge to establish Aftertouch. Escapement is easy because the model is set for 40,000ths of an inch Aftertouch. We'll add a punching. And now, escapement is very tight. Now, to be sure, I'll put the punching under the felt where it belongs and test again. And now, this is the feeling of a 30,000ths of an inch Aftertouch. When you're satisfied with your Aftertouch, call the instructor to check your work.